I want to say this example because I've said it many times. I'm sorry for my parishioners, they have to hear this again. There are too many Catholic people who are eating the bread the devil needs and praying petty prayers at the same time. And somehow, in their sick minds, they think they're okay. Many years ago, Tulio Jimenez, who does a lot of tours on Britannia, pilgrimage to Britannia, came back and gave this story. That, Father, remember that lady who wants everybody helping her pray? Oh, she wants to have a boy child, she wants to have a boy child, she wants to have a boy child. And everybody joining her to get this boy child, she wants to have a boy child. What she forgets to tell people, but what we just found out, she wants to have a boy child for somebody else's husband. What was God going to do? What God supposed to do with prayers like that? So we have people living with somebody else's husband, living with somebody else's wife, living in house commando, living in mortal sin. And as though they feel if they say no prayers or do everything else, God will get cocky. And he won't see the sin and he's just only prayers. It doesn't work so. Once you have a commitment to sin, you are inhabited by the presence of Satan. That's an evil spirit. And the more serious you sin, the more seriously sick you are. And no amount of prayers is going to make that move. What about the people in these conditions going for communion? Going for communion. And this is, to my mind, this is one of the bigger problems in the church. People who do not want to pay the price of living a life of grace, but they want everything that the life of grace is supposed to give you. It doesn't work like that. Okay.